So for the last year, there have been more than 60 burglaries at high-end houses in the Twin Cities. And these aren't smash and grabs. These are as high level as the homes they target. They're homes of pro athletes, team owners, and others. But now there's been a break in this case that came with an arrest and a guilty plea and a glimpse into how all of this went down. Here's Lou Ragus.
In a nice Eden Prairie neighborhood highlighted by a walking path, the home of Sarah and James Shazer on January 9th was broken into.
They took jewelry.
Mainly gold.
And watches and things like that. They really knew what they were doing.
The Shazers didn't realize it at the time, but they had fallen victim to what Metro Police Departments now believe is a complex burglary ring involving South American suspects that has targeted 60-plus homes across 12 Minnesota cities using sophisticated surveillance and tools like Wi-Fi and cell phone jammers. The Shazers knew it wasn't an average smash and grab when they saw how the burglars entered.
Yeah, it was not a broken window. It was a cut window.
They cut the window somehow and pulled it out and set it right on the side inside the house.
Then, 10 days later...
Sometimes you get a break in the case, and this was one of those breaks that really helped us a lot.
Eden Prairie police learned this group of Chilean nationals using fake Argentina IDs was arrested during a burglary in suburban Philadelphia. Police say the young man on the left in this photo escaped after he freed his hands from the cuffs while vomiting, then ran. With the help of Pennsylvania authorities, Eden Prairie Police Department determined that the female suspect had a ring belonging to Sarah, and this man, Miguel Guzman Pardo, had left a clear footprint in the snow outside the Shazer's window. After being extradited to Hennepin County in August, he pleaded guilty and received his sentence today. Court papers reveal the scope of the investigation into this same group by multiple police departments.
It's not just us. It's happening all over the country. It really is.
Guzman Pardo now admits he rented a car in Los Angeles on January 2nd. According to court documents, that car with California plates was then spotted over the next few days near other burglaries in Plano, Texas, Oklahoma City, Iowa, then the Twin Cities on January 9th when the Shazer home was broken into. After that, the rental car was allegedly traced to burglaries in Chicago, Ohio, then the suburbs of Philadelphia, where on January 19th, Guzman Pardo and the rest of the people in the rental car were arrested. Pennsylvania court documents say inside the rental, they found large bags filled to capacity with items, burglary tools, and a large signal jammer, a device that can disarm surveillance cameras and alarms that rely on Wi-Fi. As a second wave of these types of burglaries are affecting communities like Medina this fall, the Shazers empathize with the sense of violation other victims are feeling.
So my wedding ring of 45 years was sitting by my sink because it needed a diamond replaced in it. You know, they stole that from me. So they stole a piece of my heart.
Guzman Pardo will now be taken from the Hennepin County Jail to Ohio, where he's also facing burglary charges. Then he will face deportation. No one else from his group is currently charged in Minnesota. And as far as we know, no one from this latest round of high-end burglaries is charged either.